it's been bad. Even before the election, but we decided that
because we're going to zip it.
No, we don't want to muddy the waters because of the election.
Okay.
You understand what I mean? Because that there's national interest, and it should surpass everybody's personal interest. But you know, when she came in, it's not because she was a woman, we're supporting her. And we saw that she's a very selfish woman. Very selfish. She's your friend, eh?
No, she's not my friend.
Why is she not your friend?
Oh, me, I come there to report. I tried to interview her.
She's terrible.
I tried to even interview her. She didn't.
She won't interview.
Yeah, she didn't.
Because she has so much to hide.
I see.
So much to hide.
I see.
So much to hide. It's really shameful. And I'm not surprised because Gloria Lamte is one of her best friends.
Oh,
so they have the same trick.
Vivian Lamte, oh, I see.
Loretta Lamte.
Yeah, it's a Loretta Vivian Lamte.
The
Shrag, former Shrag boy, who went to lodge at the hotel, spending money.
Yes. Before the Super Bowl, and because I don't want to, you see, because NDC, I don't want to be seen like we are exposing NDC as against MPP. We don't want to do that. As members of the commission, we committed to be neutral. But I can tell you in confidence that she was given 250,000 Ghana cedis to go and do put up her office alone. Not that building, just decorating the office. 250,000, 2.5 million.
By who?
Oh, these people, they themselves told me. It's not like it's an open secret. Anyway, so she took the money, gave it to the consultant. That building, we don't know. Up to now, she should come and show us the letter that says that. The office was given to her. We don't know. She can't show us the letter. And we say we won't move.
Why won't you move to the apartment?
We won't move because we think it's a security risk. You see, this place, if anything happens, there are so many ways you can escape.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, that place.
The way the structures are, yeah.
We won't move. Because of it, we won't move. Then after that, you go and sign a contract with somebody and give the person a contract of almost 4 billion Ghana cedis. Almost 400,000 Ghana cedis.
So 4 million. Ghana
4 million Ghana cedis, okay. In addition to what you got, which it is, we don't know, but we know. So she went and put jacuzzi, shower cabinet, some strange chairs, electrified chairs, I don't know what that is for. I mean, it's like a home, kitchenette. So when the contractor said, but your deputies and the other commissioners, which washroom would they use? They can use what the genius are using. So I think at that point, the contractor knew that. I mean, he didn't take kindly to it. So I think he started leaking some information out. How the woman is selfish and things like that. Anyway, but I hear before the elections, too. Normally, whichever government is in power, not necessarily before elections, it can even be after elections.
Okay.
They come and say thank you. Who did it? Small. Normally, it's not much. So this one, NPC people, you know, they are more
generous.
Yes,
when it comes to
this. That's NPC people. They are the people who brought me, but they are mean. Oh, I know. I mean, I'm insulting them.
They are mean. But where is your friend? So
you need to take them to their grave. I've told them. Anyway, according to sources, they gave Felix Ofosu-Kwachi $12 million. Come and give
to the commission.
To the commission.
Not Shara.
I don't know.
The commission.
To the commission. That's seven. I agree. I told them. Anyway, according to sources, they gave Felix Ofosu-Kwachi $12 million. To come and give
to the commission.
To the commission.
Not Shara.
I don't know.
The commission.
To the commission. That's seven.
Okay.
We take some and then. You know,
and subsequently
the staff, and then even the staff,
okay.
And we are a lot. We are
thousand
something. So even if you share that money, it won't be anything bulk. Anyway, so when Felix also sensed that, according to sources, this is what I'm collecting, that when Felix also sensed that they're likely to lose, he took half of the money. Went and gave Charlotte half, $6 million.
And he took the $6 million.
And she took everything. So that actually infuriated us because you've got everything. They've sold house to you or said land, four plots at cantonment. These people came and took it from here.
MVP.
Oh, yes.
They're taking from here.
They're taking from her. But what are you, why should this help government land to you? In what capacity are you buying government land? Anyway, so as for things, she's done things,
That is what I'm interested in, especially with the election.
Oh, the election?
Yes,
especially the election. Me like this, from the election time, she doesn't talk to me. And I'm very, very eager not to talk to her. On the day of declaration, I was in the house when somebody called. We said, madam, come. Some moon is going on here, and we don't know what's going to lead us to. If you are not careful, this country will go into flames. Because the NPP people know they have lost. But we are trying very hard for there to be a runoff. And I said, who is trying very hard? So, said, madam, come, I don't want to talk on the phone. So that day I was here because I didn't want to go to the mountains. I didn't even bath. I wore my dress and I went to that place. Then the person to madam sitting. But the machine, madam, don't move here. I beg you, don't move. You are the only person who can deal with these people, so don't move. Those people are directors, so they work below us. And because we employ them, they owe some allegiance to us.
I'm sure.
So I sat there. I said, if I want to go to the washroom, I will go wait until the declaration. So I was there one day, second day, I was still there.
Yeah.
I didn't come home.
So
I then MacMenu was there, some of these people were there.
MacMenu, California,
they were there.
I was there myself.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
so
I slept there 2 days ago. I slept
when she saw that the place had been besieged, as it were, she started feeling jittery. We are not going to declare it now. We have to make sure every this thing is counted. Every ballot is counted before she started. And meanwhile, she was talking to John in between, which is not a bad thing.
John Mahama.
Yes. John is my friend. John is more my friend than Akufo-Addo. And I would have been happier because of that, although I don't particularly like NDC. But because of John, if they had won, I wouldn't mind at all.
Okay.
You understand what I mean?
Yeah.
And she knows that John is also my friend. Anyway, so she said, we have to count everything. I said, we don't have to. When we get to a stage where whatever is left, plus whatever the second person has got, won't make any difference. We will declare. We can't keep it. And there's no law that is telling us to declare what I said. There's no law. There's natural law. When the place turns into... So she saw that I wasn't, you know. So, you know, her alibis are that Muslim woman.
Hajia.
That's why she doesn't know anything. She's just walking there. Her father,
Hajia.
Can you even imagine that somebody whose father was a Northern Regional NDC chairman for a party. Yes! Up to now, that's the home that they have NDC meetings. Can you imagine? John hasn't been wise at all, and I'm waiting for the opportunity. I told him that I want to come and see him next week. I'll tell him all these things. You don't do that, you see? Me, if there's nobody I respect in this country, I respect before. You know why? For giving me that job. I have just come from Sierra Leone, I didn't know anybody. I know nobody. I mean, I knew nobody then. I met a friend of mine in traffic. Said, oh, Pauline, you are here. I haven't seen you. I said, oh, I was in Sierra Leone. And I was there for 15 years. So I lost all
your
contacts.
Yeah.
I said, oh, meet me in the office. So if you bring your CV, just in case. So I took my CV to him. The following week, he called me that the president wants to see me. So in connection with the CV. I said, hey. Me, I was taking some small job being the corner. So I went, then president, before just because he said, hey, Wesley Girls, for you are worrying me. Every CV that comes before
me. Wesley Girls.
And meanwhile, he told me. He said the people applied for that job were more than 2,000. That's at the time he was talking to me.
Wow.
And he showed me some of the letters. He said, my Mehura, one of the reasons why I'm not going to give them that job is not because they are not competent. At that time, I was 45. He said, some of them are even more experienced than you. Why? It's because you are not known.
Exactly.
In the political circles. Mm-hmm. Most of those people are known NPP people or known NDC people. And I don't want that. Because if you are a referee, you may have your party.
Your allegiance, of course.
But the perception should not be there.
Yeah. Sometimes it clouds your judgment, though.
Of course. But then you see, one, the perspective, people don't perceive you to belong to any group.
A or B. It's fine.
It helps.
Yeah, that one naturally helps.
That's how I got the job. But you there's somebody whose father, and the man was living with his father, as a chairman of NDC. But you are quite like a person. Meanwhile, she doesn't even know anything.
Wow.
When you are discussing anything, she's there. She doesn't know anything. You see, she is the one the woman is using because she doesn't know anything, obviously. But you, a Calabar woman like you, you, me, went to Westlake 7 years. You know that you can't outwit me. So I told her, we have to go to declare it. When did we declare it? On a Friday?
Yeah, it was a Friday.
So when I went,
the election was held on Wednesday.
I said,
it was being declared on Friday.
I said, I'm by the machine. And I've got the results. And what we have got right now, it was about 6 left. 6 or 16, I can't remember. We have added all the, I let the accounts people add all the rest for me, and I added to the second one. I said, nothing is going to change.
MVP had won.
I told her MVP had won. How do you know? I said, I know. And I'm not, it's not with any interest that I'm saying it. I'm saying it because that's what it is. The same way me and Afarijan also did calculation 2012 and declared NDC. This time it's MVP. Then she could start, she was teaching. She called John, go to a bathroom, but you could hear her. I guess. And I said, hey, Wanyane, that's one of my grandchildren. I have four. Anyway, so since then we haven't been on very good terms. But it was after the election that people, you know, when people lose elections,
they are bitter.
And so they talk. We got to know that all the logo matter. She said if he changes the logo, they are going to win. Oh,
really?
Oh, so many things.
So the so-called facelift.
Yes, we saw it. We are going to. Oh, we are more than them.
We choose it.
She and Ajalo and the woman, they are on one side, and we are four. So we are going. The logo, you hear about it. We don't want it. We are going back to the old one.
Then give me information. Let me start processing. Are you people ready to agitate it and you don't want the logo?
Of course, we don't want it. But first of all, but you don't have paper. How can you write?
No, I'm listening. I don't worry. I am listening.
As for the money from the NDC, I don't want to incriminate the NDC. That they gave her that money. Yes, but you can say that people with goodwill have been wanting to thank the Electoral Commission for the work they've done. And whenever she goes for the money, she chops it alone. That is a fact.
Wow.
And then also, she signed the contract. I can give you a copy if you want.
I'll be so grateful.
Hey, but you speak, you don't print. So
I have online. I do online.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yes, of course. And even with the print people.
No, sometimes. Let me tell you, the four of us, our ambition is to get it out in a month or two.
That is not possible.
It's possible. Somebody's telling it, writing that. Let the federal register speak.
But the Constitution is
not possible. No, it's possible. What do you mean by press the Constitution? Shrines, isn't the Constitution? Isn't that the same thing?
Well, it is.
Somebody is going to write to the president for investigations to the money that she, because she has flouted procurement laws. You can't give a contract a loan when it hasn't gone through the procurement process. And even the contract had no witness. She thinks we are stupid. She will go back. So we had a meeting in September. So I blasted it. When she went out, no, she went and asked the girl, the people, when I'm leaving. When I'm retiring.
He told you that the 1 year is a long time.
It's a long time.
A lot of things can happen with you.
Yeah, and I'm working on it. I want her to leave before me. Honestly.
Wow.
She has to leave before me.
So she had wanted to rig the election for the NBC.
Oh, but why was she delaying? And then, you know, that day she was in T-shirt.
She came to give us an excuse that they are collecting the results from 275 center. And until per the law, until those 275 constituencies do come in, there is no way they can declare the
result. No. But eventually they come in. Why did she declare?
Good. According to her, John Mahama had called to concede defeat.
So what?
And that is why she decided to proceed for declaring Ahmadu as the president.
It was good. Why that the people came and that she didn't want to see them? Where did that
exist? I know what is his name. Otofi, Adikoka, and Mosquito. They went to her office.
Uh-huh.
That was the time I realized that they said they were going to reject the electronic transmission result or something. Oh. They were protesting against it or something.
Yeah. She's out anyway. She'll go. Yes, Loretta went. Loretta too is a constitutional body.
If they investigate, of course.
Of course. Then somebody is going to write. I know people who are ready to write. Oh, where is it? But you saw it in what's the name of that paper?
Alhaji newspaper.
No, not Alhaji. Oh, where is it? You give a contract and you alone, and this one is not even part of our procurement process. Here is her ex-boyfriend. Yes. Oh, as for the boyfriends, there are many. The one who will make your Omega, what's the name? The former Minister of Finance.
Comrade before.
What's what they are, they did there for more than 10 years.
Wow.
Oh, Jesus. That one is also another story. Morally corrupt. Then she signed. No witness. She has no right to give a contract like this. That's all.
So this was for the person's coming, do what for the letter commission? Contract for the construction of fit out.
Partition. Just partition.
Of new offices.
Yes. Partition, that's all. And we have no documents to say that office had been given to us. You know, you can only work in an office when it has been officially given to you. If by word of mouth somebody says move here, we are not ready to move because we haven't seen the letter.
Can I take pictures?
You can take it. It will blow very soon. Somebody is going to even write to the president.
Petition the president.
Yeah, because this